Hello everyone, Ictus here, and in today's video, I will be showing you guys how to sign up to the Amazon AWS framework and how to create a Kali Linux server on the cloud all for free. After we have done that, on part 2 of this series, I will show you how to use the Cloud Kali server to obtain a remote connection to any Windows machine using a bad USB in under 5 seconds. Don't worry about part 2 for now. I will explain everything in detail on how we will hack the Windows machine in the next part. What we will try to achieve is to create a server on the cloud that will host a backdoor file on Apache 2, and with a bad USB we will download and execute the file, and we will also turn off the Windows Defender real-time protection to secure the remote connection. So without further ado, let's get started. Like I said, today we will only be creating the AWS Kali Linux server. So I will need to head on the AWS website and then log in to my account. If you guys already have an account, you can just log in, but if you don't, then please pause the video and create a new account. I do have to mention though that in order to create an account, you need a credit card or a debit card. This will not charge you anything. It's just a mandatory thing for the registration process. So I will sign in. If you have successfully signed up on the AWS platform, you should get a page like this one with the management console. From there, you will need to click to the EC2, which is the AWS virtual server. Then click on Launch Instance. Select the AWS Marketplace and search for Kali. We should get the latest version of the Kali Linux from Offensive Security. So now I'm just going to select this. Now we can see the pricing for the Kali machine, but because we are using the free tier, we don't actually have to pay anything, so you can actually select any machine that has the free tier available. But for the sake of this video, we're going to use the Kali Linux machine. I'm going to continue. Now we can create our key pair to actually connect to the machine with SSH. So I will select create a new key pair. I will call this Kali Server Video 2 because I already have one for the test. And I will download the key pair. It already exists. Okay, so I will change the name of this to 3 and download the key pair. I will save the file on my downloads and I will launch the instance. This may take a while if this is your first time launching an instance, so please give this some time. Great, so now it says that our instances are launching. So now we'll head back to the AWS Management Console, click on EC2, and I will select the instances right here. We can see right here that our instance is pending right now. Ignore the first one, this was for a test, and now we can see that the instance started running. I will give this a name. I will call this Kali Server Video. I will select the machine from here. And now we are inside the machine and we can see all of the information. We can see the public IPv4 address and we can see the private IPv4 address. Now what we want to do is actually SSH to the machine. So remember, we downloaded the key pair to give the SSH connection. I'll go to my downloads. I will copy the file and I will paste it on the desktop. There we go. So now I will go to my terminal. And I will change my directory to the desktop directory. We can see that the file is located inside the desktop directory. So now what we want to do is SSH to the machine and actually give SSH the key pair that we downloaded from AWS. So to do that, we will write down SSH dash I, we will specify the name of the file, and now we will specify the user and the public IP address of the instance. I will copy the public IPv4 address and I will paste it here. We're going to type yes. And we can see that it says that the file is unprotected. So now what we have to do is actually change the permissions of the file. In order to do that, you have to do chmod 700 and then specify the name of the file. I will now SSH to the machine, and we can see that we are in. Now this is great, this means that we have successfully SSH'd to the machine, and to confirm that we can do ifconfig, and we can see that our IP here is the same with this one, the private IPv4 address. So congrats so far, we've managed to create our instance on the cloud, and we also managed to SSH to it. So now I'm going to run a simple test on the machine. I will try to install Apache 2 and run the default web page on it. So to do that, I will firstly have to become root. I will clear my screen. And now I will try to update the repositories of the Kali machine. Great, so now I will attempt to download the Apache 2. I don't know if it's already downloaded, but I will attempt it. I have to make sure that I don't do any typos. And I believe it was not downloaded or installed. So now it is installing Apache 2. Great. So now we can do service Apache 2 start. And we can go on our browser, take the public IPv4 address and paste it on the search bar. Now this should give us the default Apache 2 greeting page. So let's have a look. As you can see, it is not loading, but I know why. I forgot to port forward port 80 from the security page. So now to do that, I have to go to security, security groups, and select this one. Edit the inbound rules. I will add a new rule and I will select HTTP. I will save the rules. And now, if we refresh the page, we can see that the Apache default page is coming up. So this is great progress so far. I believe this is all for today's video. This is part one. And on part two of this series, I will show you guys how to host a backdoor on this Kali server and how to obtain a remote connection to any Windows machine in under 5 seconds using a bad USB. So with that all said, thank you for watching and I'll see you next week.